Oh, I'm so refreshed. All right. I got to go and talk to Snake. I have nothing against you. Maybe I can even help you. You appear useless, but also harmless. Help me open this gate. I have these instructions, and apparently I need a key. My lockpicks won't work. Bring me the key, and we'll talk. Make one, or find it. I don't care. Okay, I need something behind this door too, so I'll try to help. You can take these instructions. You need to use a keeper's key with this instruction at a study table. Keeper's key. I don't have a keeper's key. Well, now that feels like a waste of faith. Kind of ironic, putting my faith in things and I'm starting to feel like they're a waste. Cool new area. Beeswax and honey. Nice. I think I'll keep on collecting this honey. So I got sand. More honey. The fuck is this thing? Maybe a coal vein? Yep. It's almost nighttime. I probably oughtn't be out here in the middle of the fucking forest at night. That does seem like a terrible idea. Another damn spot I gotta clear out. God dang, man. It's almost Monday morning. The Inquisitor told me to meet him at Witch Hill. My good buddy, the Inquisitor, up on Witch Hill. Angry asshole. That guy who pushes everything of his on to you. Like you need to think this way or you're not a good person. Ah, Keeper, enjoy the air here. There's something righteous in it. It is good to know that we'll soon be burning another witch here. We're still torturing her. But forgiveness is worth it. This time the burning should go perfect. We need to prove that no witch can escape our righteousness. We need to make some preparations here. You can aid the Holy Inquisition. We need some firewood for a nice warm fire, and as many advertising flyers as you can get. You need me to... I'll wait for you. The witch isn't going anywhere. As soon as we have everything ready, we'll burn her. What's with the other half of the graveyard?
Yes. There was a curse many years ago, and still the evil is somewhere nearby. So I need to be sure that you're on our side in this fight before I give you permission to use this part of the graveyard again.
How do I make the flyers? I guess I'll go and figure out how to make flyers. Well, that's cool. I didn't see it before because I wasn't paying attention, I guess. But there's a quarry. Monday is about to be done with, and I gotta go and talk to the astrologer tomorrow on Moonday, so I guess I'll go to sleep. Go the fuck to sleep. Hopefully when I wake up I can go talk to the astrologer, bring him this old skull, and I'll have another mission done. I'm so refreshed. I don't feel like if I'm walking across town. Give him the skull. Not terribly clean. But what every bone is in its place. Seems you have a talent for anatomy. The
The human body is so mysterious, perhaps even more than the sun and stars. I believe one day you'll learn much about the human body and the soul, and then you will find yourself absolutely lost. Now, as we are now partners in crime, what is it you want from me, my curious friend?
I need your help. I need ink and paper.
I have some. Actually, I have lots of useful things. Some of it may be useful for a beginning scientist such as yourself. I can't stand those chumps at the university. I'd rather earn a little extra coin elsewhere.
A friend told me that you might know how to activate the portal on Witch Hill.
Never heard about it. Maybe not exactly never, but at least not for many years. In another life, I had a friend. By the way, he was a graveyard keeper like you, and he was mad about this portal. He was so imaginative, he knew so much.
Was his name Gary?
Actually, I don't know his name. We always used to call him by his nickname, Keeper.
What happened to him?
He just disappeared. Hasn't been seen or heard from since. I tried to find him, but nobody knew him. I even started thinking he was just a figment of my imagination. It was a hard time for me.
So what about the portal?
I think he found a way. Activate it. It was something magical, so I don't remember. But it should be in his diary. Just before his disappearance, he gave me this key. It opens a metal gate in the northern part of the church cellar. Somewhere in there is where he kept his most important notes.
Why didn't you take these notes?
Oh, I tried. But there's a secret to this key. I tried for months to figure out how it works. Maybe it's just in my mind and the key opens nothing. Anyway, you can take it. Try to learn how the key works at the study table in the church cellar. When you have his diary, bring it to me and I'll try to find some information about the portal.
Well, I got the keeper key that I needed to get. Now I just gotta run back through town, see if asshole poet motherfucker is gonna take this ink off of me, because I need to give it to him so it's not in my inventory. He said he needed 10 paper, but I only got one. Hey, motherfucker. Give him the ink.
Great, this ink is blood of poetry. That sounds good. I should write that down.
Need more faith. I need science. I don't know how the hell I'm gonna get science. So refreshed. I feel like I might be late because I gotta go and give the sermon, and I gotta give that stuck-up prick his bowls so he can look nice for his soup kitchen. I'd like to say some words. Our church is great.
Nice.
And now let us pray for this blessing.
Nice, okay.
Your donations are welcome.
Great sermon.
Whew, they're ugly, but they're just perfect for the poor people.
I am pleased to note your involvement in this business of the church. I might even consider upgrading your church to a big church. That means more faith and more money. With a big church, you'll be closer to God, and what's more important to me than holiness? But all of this is far in the future. First, everything here has to be perfect as my haircut. And I mean both the church inside and the graveyard outside.
Ha
I'll do my best to meet your high standards.
Speaking of high standards, I'd be so pleased if you could provide me with some fish. It'll save me from starvation. And not just any fish. I need a quality fish fillet. I believe you can find that kind of fish near the waterfall.
You mean the town is starving, right?
No, I can't eat meat, and as for the fish from the town harbor, well, no thank you. Not with that rotten ship of the dead half floating there. So you're my only hope. I think I've started losing my hair on account of my bad diet.
All right, asshole. I ain't talking to you anymore right now. All right. I think that's enough for this episode. Thanks for watching Graveyard Keeper, and I hope you come back for the next one. Bye.